Tell me what you got here, Harry.
Oh, it's going to take too much.
Oh, you can do it in 3 minutes.
No, this is, these are Books of Common Prayer from 1740. We got two of them, and they've got all the changes. See, they did
handwritten changes
all through it. It's really cool. I just found out here we got another one from 1740. Wow. Two Books of Common Prayer. This is the first edition of the from 1795. So it's got prayers in there about president and the Congress, you know, the governing leaders, but this is all the king, right? So here's, these are books we found up in that new room I told you about. These are-
You just found these recently?
Yeah, just this week.
Get out of here.
Yeah, we just have a whole box of, this is all the children's for their Sunday school.
Wow.
From the 1800s.
Up in the tower.
Yeah, up in the tower.
What's this stuff over here?
Well, this is a Bible from 1730. So
That was in the building here?
Yeah, well, this was given to us. This was a family. It's a family Bible, and they gave it to us in the 1800s. Okay, so they donated this. This is the cover. You know, and those are just blank pages.
What's this thing over here?
Well, this, I believe this was the charter for the land out in Ewing from 1703, because I think this is signed in England. We have a transcription of it, but I haven't spent the time to read it yet. I mean, read the whole thing. So this goes way back, and I got to get another, the glass broke on the front of it. I got to get another glass for it. And this is just some of our, this is the earliest Book of the Vestry book. And the earliest dates on here are 1755. We got some records from the Vestry. All beautiful, beautiful handwritten. And some of our birth and death records are in the back there. But I've got all the birth and death records in the cabinet. This is interesting because this was the very first handwritten charter of the church after they reopened the church after the revolution.
Wow, look at the penmanship.
Yeah, it's just incredible. So it goes, you know, it goes on for a couple pages and then it becomes the vestry book. So it's all of there, but it's just perfectly written, laid out. It's really neat. And then it's the vestry minutes, which again, I haven't photographed and read. But you know, we've got a whole bunch of the vestry minutes. This here, these are all different manuscripts, and these were found. This is the sermon that we're working with
for the play.
For the play, yeah. When I found these here, you can see one of the handwriting on the.
That's also from the
1770. That's from the 1770, yeah.
Pretty cool.
Yeah, it's neat. It's just cool. So, and here's, we just got a lot of different letters and manuscripts. And I photographed everything already. And I don't remember. That was months ago. So it was just neat. I just photographed them. Didn't spend a lot of time sitting down and reading them because you don't want to possibly messy, you know.
What's with these bronze pieces?
Oh, I don't know. I don't know anything about that. They're probably from the 70s or 80s.
Okay.
There's some neat things. I mean, I photographed everything to go to ancestry.com. These are just the regular church records from 1900 on.
Mm-hmm.
So I gave them over to the diocese and they were doing a project for Ancestry. But I didn't want to let all the other ones go out. So I did the photographs. So these are our birth and death records. So from essentially going back, I think I have more up here.
Is there original artwork in this church? Like it's been around for a long time?
Some of the silver stuff went to, I mean, this was some, went to the State Museum years ago.
Yeah.
I don't got anything more. Yeah, this is just the vestry minutes. I'm looking for the cover of it. So, yeah, this shelf was just full when I came in. a bunch of these books were down in the bottom, but there was furniture in front of here and boxes of old technology, you know, like old computer printers and stuff, and like six different Mr. Coffees from 1960 on, right? And this was a utility closet. I mean, this was utility shelving. So I'll show you. I mean, I took the stuff out and filled up our utility room. I mean, you know, like pesticides and all this stuff for the bathrooms and, you know, also all the like Christmas, like points, the stuff for raising money for poinsettia sales, you know, all the little cards and envelopes, just jam packed. It was like a mishmash. And I said, how could anybody, you know, what do you work with this? So it'd been like 20 years. They haven't had a pastor here for, I mean, the last pastor probably was still adding to it. But they haven't had a pastor here for like 4 years. And the one that came wasn't planning on staying very long. You know, they were just turnovers pretty quick. So nobody ever, what happened is all these manuscripts and some of this, the valuable stuff was all in this vault. And I think, I mean, I have someplace the papers, the paperwork where they filled out the papers for the vault. So it probably was put in about the 1920s. I don't think the handwriting didn't look like the 1880s or anything. So it was about the 1920s that they put it in one of the banks downtown and you know, signed off everything. Maybe the 1910s, you know. But when the bank closed, they emptied the vault, and that was in the 2000s. So 2005, 2006, I've asked, they couldn't remember when. And everything came back here and they just put it on the shelf because nobody was working here.
Oh.
And that's why, you know, I found it under, literally, I found it under the urinal tablets. I don't want to, I mean,
That's amazing this stuff is still here.
Yeah. It was like, and we got, I was, somebody who was down in Bordentown was tracing Napoleon Bonaparte's brothers, you know, life down there in Bordentown. And he had a don't want to say a bastard daughter, but he, you know, he had a daughter by his mistress that was with him here. And she's buried here in our churchyard. And the lady had asked if there's, you know, she was trying to trace this, the daughter's family, I mean, had, or the mother's family.
What was her name?
I don't remember that. And she's from parent from around here.
Was Bonaparte's daughter's name?
Oh, again, I don't, oh, I'm okay, bad with names. I don't
but
even
she's out there somewhere
name.
In the
graveyard. Yeah, yeah, I'll show you where she is sometime. Okay. So anyway, that's when I said, wow, let me find the cemetery records. So that's what really drove me at this. I said, I see some books down there, maybe, you know, and then what's locked up? And I that's when I said, what's in here? You know, and Fred said, well, here's how to open it, but we are, you know, they didn't use it. I mean, it was filled up of anything that somebody, you know, people's purses that were left, the lost and found, and down the bottom were all these books. And I said, let me see if I find cemetery records. I still haven't found cemetery records.